What's up, guys? We are in Charlotte, North Carolina at the airport right now. It's been a very early morning. We left D.C. this morning about 6:45, left the house a little after 5 a.m., headed to Nassau in the Bahamas, going to Sandals Royal Bahamian. Really looking forward to it. Should be a really fun trip. So next time you see us, we will be landing in the Bahamas. Drinking?
Mine.
What is it?
Alcoholic.
What else is it?
Yes.
Have you eaten today?
Nope.
Is that dangerous?
It is 2:30. I have zero food and now half of one of these of red sangria now. Very good. Good day.
Are you thriving?
A little bit.
Or are you King Boo?
I'm King Boo. I'm so hungry right now.
Hannah got fish tacos. That's Bahamian mac and cheese. Hannah needs this badly or she might die. Well, I got the conch fritters with an island calypso sauce. And yeah, we need this incredibly badly because all we have in our stomachs right now is alcohol.
I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna start with the mac and cheese.
Try it.
The mac and cheese looks good.
Try it. Let me know your thoughts. It looks like really good, like, creamy mac and cheese.
It is, but it's like actual cheese, too. Like, you know, it's not like the Kraft mac and cheese, where it's like, you love it, but you know it's fake. This is, like, real cheese, and it's got, like, a little bit of pepper in there. You can taste it, but it's not overwhelming. It's perfect. I love it.
Let me know.
Is this going to fall apart?
I was about to say, that's a big piece of fish.
All right. Let's get something off.
Dig in. First bite of food. I know her faces, that's a 10 out of 10. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now we gotta try the conch fritter. Tell you what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna try it without the calypso sauce first, just want the raw bite, and then we'll go in.
That's almost cheating though. I love conch fritters, I already know I love conch fritters. Now we gotta try it with the sauce.
What's in the sauce?
No idea. It's mayo based, so I know that.
Ew, mayo.
It's fantastic though. 10 out of 10, no notes. We get three on a plate, but I could easily eat 10 of these without realizing what I'd done, and then I'd have to go lay down for a while because I'd made a huge mistake.
So Sandals pro tip number one, make sure you get multiple orders of the conch fritters.
Easy place to start, multiple conch fritters.
So we finally made it in today and we just got into our room. They let us in. We're room 203 in the East Bay. So that means second floor, third room. Want to check it out? Let's check it out. We go through our door. And here's the room. So it's a pretty good like hotel room, I would say, as far as this is one of the rooms without a balcony. It's one of the first things you might notice. But I don't think you really need a balcony as far as you look at this view. I mean, this is so cool. You get great views both of the water and some of the activities going on. You can people watch really good from up here. I'm not mad about this, given that we got this on their Black Friday sale, so I'm pretty happy with this. But yeah, so now that the view, I think, is the central part of this, well, let's check out the rest of the room. So you're here, you have your pretty standard four-poster bed. You have two side tables, one with a chair. You have another extra chair here. You have your whole TV station with everything, including the mini bar, your coffee, your tea. You've got your glassware, an ice bucket, your wine. If you come over in here, you get your pretty standard mini fridge with all the good stuff in it, right? So of course this is all complimentary. You got your juices, your wine. Got some beer, so I'm really excited to try the local beer. Since we are big beer people, lots of bottled water. I love that, lots of bottled water. It's hot here, you need to keep hydrated. So I like that there's quite a few storage bins right here. I think this is just empty storage, just plenty of place to put stuff. Which when you're here for a week is really nice. Like I pack, I don't know about you, I way overpack. So so I really appreciate that. Anyway, going back to where we first started off, of course you have your big full-length mirror. Say hi, Joe.
Hi.
To get ready to get in, of course, the bathroom. It's a nice bathroom. I love the massive mirror, honestly. It's backlit, too, so if you're doing your makeup, I really enjoy that. Plenty of space, plenty of counter space, too, which is also very important when you're staying in one place for a week. You can tell it's been redone relatively recently, which I also like. And of course, then you have the shower, which this is actually really nice. It's of course walk-in shower, but it's big size. You got everything you need. You got plenty of spaces to put your stuff in there. You have a towel bar so you can hang your towels when you're done. I'm pretty happy with this. This is pretty good. And I guess last but not least is the closet. For if you're like me and you overpack, you need all of this space. And this is just a ton of room. It goes way back in there. There's a ton of hangers, everything you really need, extra pillows. You got a safe, which I really like. And you get it. And this is actually double doored too, so it looked big, but you can actually access the other side pretty easily. So easy peasy, you got it. So this is a sick drink. It's soy and sake cruise. I don't know what's in it, but it's fruity. There's pineapple in it, and I'm gonna try it and tell you about it.
There's definitely sake in it.
That's refreshing. It's refreshing. Like, this is like, I wish I were outside on the beach right now, and you know, a little bit on the like hot side. Like, oh, I need something to cool down. This is exactly what you want. It is pretty. It is mild. You don't taste the sake. You don't taste the whatever else is in this other than it's fruity and cold and refreshing. It's so delightful. This is good. I'd order like a lot of these.
Take your chopsticks. Yep. You lay them across like a bridge. Take your shot of sake. You place them on your chopsticks. You balance it as so. And then we sing the all important song.
Sing it for me.
Na na na. Na 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 na. Hey, hey, hey. Sake bomb. And you chug down the hatch. That is how you do a sake bomb.
You can see all of it. It's beautiful. The nigiri is not out yet, but this is a very good start. We're very excited.
The tuna, the albacore, the amago, that's the egg, the squid, that's one of Hannah's favorites. The shrimp, that one's my favorite.
It's eel, not squid.
I'm sorry, it's eel. You're right, we didn't get that. That's eel. Hannah's right. And the salmon looks perfect. Two pieces of each. Little windy out right now, but enjoying the sunset from this pier. We got our Adirondack chairs. Beautiful life. We just ate way too much sushi and drank way too much alcohol. But not to worry, we have more alcohol. Cheers, my love. Not bad for our first night, Sandals Royal Bahamian, Nassau, Bahamas. Pretty perfect.
It could be worse.
It could be worse.
Pretty good.
Just so we're aware too. You see over there? Private island. That's gonna be us tomorrow. For now, just gonna soak this in. We are at some late night dinner tonight. We are over at the English pub. I've got some buffalo wings, some carrots, some fries, and blue cheese dressing. Hannah has got the chowder.
I got the corn chowder, and it comes with toast. Looks really good.
There's the toast.
All right, good morning. It is our first full day on the island and at the resort. We slept in a little bit, you know. Had a lazy morning. We went to breakfast. Went to La Plume actually for breakfast, which is their sit-down
French press coffee.
You come
You come to La Plume in the morning and you order coffee. They just give you a French press for your table. They said it takes 3 to 4 minutes to brew, and you press down and serve. That's pretty cool. I don't think I've ever been anywhere where they just gave you a French press.
No, not at Sandals. Usually they just give you a carafe. I'm like, ooh, I get fancy coffee.
As opposed to Canoe, which is the buffet breakfast, I got a really good Eggs Benedict, and they have these triangles of like fried potato hash browns. And we had those last time we were at a Sandals resort, actually at South Coast in Jamaica, and I fell in love with them. It's just a simple fried potato patty, and it is so good. It's fried perfectly crispy. It's like not at all greasy. It's good size too. And like, I've been dreaming about them for the last year, so I'm so excited that finally.
She literally talks about them all the time. How much she wants one of those potato triangles.
So good. I love them.
So just what we're doing now, we're sitting here on the dock. We're trying to catch the 10 a.m. boat over to the island. We'll show around there once we get over there. The boat left kind of early, so we're a little confused as to what might be happening right now.
So we showed up about 15 minutes early. The first one's supposed to leave at 10, but it looks like they maybe had a full boat. So they said, okay, let's go to the island. So we're waiting around to see if the boat will come back and have a 10 a.m. There's certainly a whole bunch of people waiting up here. Maybe we can see them in the background.
Yeah, I see.
So
people are kind of saying, what the hell, just like us. So
I think there's going to be a lot of us. So I'm thinking they're going to do a second one. We'll see. Hopefully we'll get on.
It's the island is literally only a half mile offshore, too. Like, you can kind of see it over there. I don't know how well you can see it, but it's literally right over there. So, you know, the round trip can't take more than 20, 30 minutes total.
Oh, not even. I think it took them less than 5 minutes to get over there. They look docked now.
Yeah.
Hopefully, we'll see. Hopefully, we'll show you the island in shortly. If not, they do the shuttle on the hour, I guess a little boat trip on the hour. So if we don't make it in 10 minutes, we'll be there in an hour.
Regardless, next thing we'll see will be us on the island. Awesome. Eventually. Make it to the island. I would have kept filming to show it, but rum punch was more important. So, but now we set our stuff down. We got our home base set up under a nice little shady spot, and we're gonna head around the island, just kind of explore a little bit, see what we see.
Yep. So you see the bar behind us there. If we go this way, this is the pool. It's not a very big pool, but it is nice. There's a pool bar and
beautiful loungers.
Yeah, tons of lounge chairs. It's super cloudy today too, which is actually kind of nice because it's very hot. So I'm actually not mad about some of this cloud cover we're currently getting. I see a lot of people out in the water right now. It's a great day for swimming because it is so hot. I've seen a couple people with their own snorkel gear too. We're going to bust ours out here in a little bit after we kind of walk around and explore. We just kind of want to get a lay of the land. As we come up, you can kind of see as we go too, just how pretty the landscaping is, and they really take care of it. They've got these nice little swing chairs here. Very romantic. You know, have a nice couple's day.
Hidden area over here.
Yeah.
So many tucked away places to sit. It's really nice.
We'll show you the place we set up as our base camp. We've discovered these little lounge chairs. They're like rocking bean bags almost.
They're dangerous.
And they're very dangerous. One, because you don't want to get out of them. And two, you can't get out of them because we're both 30 and that's just not how our joints work anymore.
Base camp, we were sweaty, so we hung up our clothing, but you can see these little lounge beach.
We'll come through here. Yeah, you can kind of see what I'm talking about. Oh, wow.
Oh, look.
As you can see, this tiny little hermit crab.
My friend.
Tiny little hermit crab, just a baby.
I believe in you.
Hey, he wants no part of us. He's trying to get away. Unfortunately, when your legs are that small.
Why did the hermit crab cross the road?
Because it saw me coming and knew I would know interesting facts about it.
Tell me an interesting hermit crab fact.
They can't be alone. They get very lonely and they die.
Really?
Yes. Huh. You always have to buy them in pairs. At least pairs. Also, don't buy hermit crabs.
Yeah.
Just pro tip. Don't buy the hermit crabs. Don't do it. We're kind of approaching the end of the island here, like literally the tip, and also the end of the property as a result. There's a couple loungers out here. This is so secluded. Like, this is the, you want peace, quiet, and to be away from everybody. Clearly. Well, I'm looking at these chairs right here, and if these aren't taken, maybe we do the same.
Yeah, I love, like, as we do this. This is our first one.
Yeah, you.
We set our stuff down the first kind of, set of chairs that looked okay, and we're like, ooh, we found these beanbag chairs. Now we're like, ooh,
Maybe we can move right here.
Do you want to move over here?
Honestly, maybe.
This is a, it's really nice, it's really secluded. There's a memorial plaque of some kind over here. It's a memorial to Butch, the founder of Sandals.
Yeah.
We're actually going to eat dinner later at Butch's steak chop house, which is named for him. And again, you can just see this, like, do the full panorama here of what's around us, and you can tell we really truly are in paradise here.
I just have to show this real quick. We're sitting here at lunch on the island, and this chicken has approached us. Kind of makes me feel better that we didn't get a chicken dish, because there's one right there, and how would we explain it to her?
I'd be so sad.
Where did she, is she?
Oh, she's right below the table.
Like, it feels like being back in Hawaii, that there's just a chicken wandering. Oh, she's flying. So yeah, random chicken during lunch today. You never know what you'll find in the Bahamas. So our food just came out. I got the grouper goujon, which is just like the fried grouper with fries, pretty standard. Hannah got a shrimp salad, basically. I don't remember
what it was called, though. Shrimp something.
Yeah, shrimp started with a T, but it's basically a shrimp salad. So it's got like some sort of vinaigrette on it, some sort of citrus.
And some grilled onions. And
yeah, so, all right. Well, what do you think? Let's give us the...
Let's have a bite. Let's start with the lettuce. Well, you can't tell, but there's like a nice citrusy-ish, and not very heavy, which is good. I like that.
It looks very light.
Mm-hmm. Very light. But it tastes good. It's very fresh. It's a hot day, so this is perfect for a hot day.
Cool. Try the shrimp. What do you think about that?
Well, let's get this little guy off. There we go. This is good shrimp. It's good fresh shrimp. So there's a little bit of that citrusy marinade on it too. It's again very refreshing. It's perfect for a hot day. I love it. Recommend.
I got the grouper goujon. It's like these fried grouper nuggets, basically. So start with that. Just gonna try it. It's really good. It's really, really crunchy and well fried. It's delicious, first of all. It's got like a fish stick kind of taste, but like a really high quality fish stick. Pretty sure I know how this is gonna be. Seems like a pretty standard French fry. It's exactly what you expect it to be, but it's exactly what you want it to be. This is great. I would highly recommend getting this. If you want some seafood that's pretty, it's fried, so it's gonna be a little heavier than Hannah's salad, but that's really, really good. I really like that.
We have moved our base camp on the island. There's a storm coming in. I'll show you the clouds in a minute. See what we found. There's Hannah. We found this wonderful little cover. I think we are going to ride out that nastiness right here. And you can see our view is clearly terrible and we are clearly not thriving.
Worst.
Not too shabby. Love this island.
So our appetizers at Butch's just arrived. Hannah's got the goat cheese salad. It's a crispy block of goat cheese, by the way. So. Very excited. And I have got the Dungeness crab cake. It's a pretty good sized crab cake.
That's big.
With an island slaw. And you want to let me know how it is?
I'll start with the actual salad itself. There's no pretty way to eat this. I'm thinking this is a fancy restaurant.
Just dive on in, babe. Looks pretty standard. Try the goat cheese. That's what we're.
It's like a. It's not like lettuce.
But the goat cheese is what we're here for. Look at that. I think that's an approval.
So good. It's like a nice creamy goat cheese. Like,
yeah.
Goat cheese tends to be a little bit more tart and creamy, and it's not like a solid chunky. It's not like a mozzarella stick. It's like a warm, like a bomb of like warm, gooey goodness. Think like something, you put that on mac and cheese or anything. It's quite good. But it's fried, so it's even better because, of course, fried is pretty good.
So here we go. The food is out. It's Hannah's Steak Diane. We got three sides. We got the asparagus, the Brussels sprouts, and the mushrooms, sauteed mushrooms. And I got the T-bone. And then because of who we are, we also got the surf and turf to split. It's a lobster tail with butter and a filet mignon. And we're also waiting on, we got two more of the signature cocktails coming. So.
I'm so ready to dig in right now.
It looks great. It smells great. I assume it's great. So Hannah, we got a couple bites in now. Give me your thoughts.
My coconut crab is very good.
They're really well cooked. The Diane sauce for Hannah is really good. Mine, perfectly cooked. You can see how rare that is, just the way I like it.
Okay, by well cooked, he means cooked right.
Cooked perfectly.
Not well done. No, I asked for medium rare. This is very medium rare.
I don't want a well-done steak. I can go eat a doorstop somewhere else. But it's everything is perfect so far. We love it. Look how well that's cooked. Look how perfect that's cooked.
So good. The sauce is good. I'm usually not a sauce person. People
don't. I get why. It's you have to get the reservations. And you really have to make sure you get them. Butch's Chop House. I think we would both really recommend. Get your reservations. Get them in. We had an 8:30 reservation tonight. It was worth the wait. So wrapping up at Butch's, our dessert just came. I got the chocolate sin pie. It's obviously chocolate. Comes with ice cream. Hannah got the Willy Wonka creme brulee. Comes with caramel popcorn, which I think is really fun and really exciting. Hannah? Oh, phoneception.
Oh, that's a photo.
Oh.
I just took one photo.
I'm videoing.
I tried to take like a nice like video, like let me see like get all the details.
Well, here, push them together.
One photo. No. It's fine.
See right now.
It's fine.
We'll break into the creme brulee. Let's see this thing.
All right. Okay. Last time I had creme brulee to Sandals, it tasted like. Egg curd.
Agreed.
It was not that good. I was a little. It was fine. Whatever. I dealt with it. I don't care. I'm on vacation. But this is for Berlin. They did it right this time. It's
gonna it be nice. Looks good.
Caramel flavor to it. Got a good consistency. It's got popcorn on it.
So I'm trying to try the chocolate sin pie. Very chocolatey. Tell that just from looking at it. Oh my goodness. If you ate two plates of this, you'd be in a coma. Like, holy cow. You almost need the ice cream, like the vanilla ice cream, to balance out how chocolatey that is. Yeah, the two, you need both. This is incredible, but holy cow, that is dense. I'm gonna go through the buffet here. Grab your plate, all kinds of fruit, cereals, old milk. You got all the peanuts. Awesome selection of breads, muffins. Show off what we got here. Go up for the Eggs Benedict. Ken's got some fruit, some cold cuts. I'm excited to try this. It's like a goat cheese quiche thing. And you know I had to get a muffin. It is the morning of our second full day. We're starting this out over at one of the pools. We We just got back. The dive shop and the aquatic center blew these up for us. They were super friendly people over there, and if you ask them nicely, they will use a scuba tank to actually blow up your inflatables for you, save you the lightheadedness. So, good pro tip.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground, where I spent my days chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool, shooting some meatball outside the school with a couple of guys who were up to no good. Started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're going away with your uncle and your auntie in Bel Air."
Give him a round of applause. That was good. I give it an 8 out of 10.
Tesoro for lunch. They do pizza for lunch. I think
and salads.
Hannah's right, and salads. I think I'm gonna do the shrimp and she's gonna do the fig and prosciutto. So we'll see how they come out.
And I got the fig and prosciutto pizza, which I'm really excited for. They really loaded me up on all of the different toppings, and this might be a fork and knife pizza. I don't know. We're gonna try it. It's hot. Goodness. All right.
Look at that cheese pull.
Let's get a little bit.
Oh my.
On here. Let's do this by hand, guys.
Slower.
That was an amazing cheese pull. Oh, bud. Like the arugula is a little bit of fresh. It's really good. Very cheesy. Very hot. And fresh. And of course, prosciutto.
I got the shrimp and roasted garlic pizza. It's got fresh red peppers on it. And I was like, shrimp sounds like a very interesting pizza topping. I gotta try it. You know, get pepper on your home. You're in the office. Do something unique. Already had a slice and it's really good. Shrimp is a very interesting pizza topping. I don't know if it totally works, but I do love shrimp, so I'm rolling with it. But overall, I like it. They make really good pizza in Sandals. Or when we had it the first time in Sandals South Coast, we were very shocked because we expected, oh, it's pizza. But no, it was actually really good.
We are at Gordon's on the Pier for dinner tonight. You see the menu, and most importantly, you see that view. That's the real reason to come here. But there's the better view. I think we've been looking over the menu. I'm looking at those pan-fried scallops and the pork porterhouse. And what were you thinking?
I'm thinking of the Bahamian fish chowder and the swordfish steak.
And I think we're just going to do one of each of the desserts and call it good.
All right, so our appetizers have just come out. These are the pan-fried scallops as it comes on a piece of toast. It looks like it smells like barbecue sauce, actually, so very interested to try that.
I got the Bahamian fish chowder. It's got some good chunks of, like, some fish in there, vegetables. I can see it steaming hot, so I'm kind of afraid of trying it right now.
Yeah.
But I'm going to stir it to cool it and try it in a second.
I can tell, though, there's decent chunks of seafood in there. Like, they really didn't mess around.
Just some of the soup itself. It tastes like fish, but it's not fishy, you know? It's good fishy.
Yeah.
It's gonna sound wrong, I know, but it's good fishy.
Like I said, they've got some sort of barbecue sauce on it, I think, so I'm a little curious what that's about. We're gonna try it.
Tannino's scallops are one of my absolute favorite things. I love them. Just ready for them. It is a barbecue sauce. It's not like your traditional, like you might think. It's not like a sweet barbecue sauce or anything. It's more tangy, but it's really nice. And looks like actually on this toast, there's some pulled pork too. So I think that's actually what that's gonna go well with. But this is really good. I would happily get this. You can get 7 orders of this and be very happy. So would recommend. Entrees are here. That is Hannah's swordfish steak. I know it's a little dark, but you can see it pretty well. It's got potatoes, mixed vegetables with it. And it looks really well seasoned, so yes. Cut in and let's see.
It is the signature dish, so we'll see. I love a good swordfish steak, though.
what's the word?
It's very good. Go ahead, good.
Okay.
It's something that you expect from swordfish. You expect a steak of fish, but the fish hurt. I will say, it's very light on the seasoning. I maybe wish there was a little bit more salt or pepper or cayenne. I don't know, maybe that's the Louisiana name. This is very good, and it will set the lack of seasoning. Let the flavor shine through.
Sweet songs, melodies pure and true. This is my message to you, boo-boo.
So today we are going to drink the rainbow, and this is something that we started last time we were at South Coast. We got tired of drinking the same couple of things, so we decided let's try something of every color, go up to the bartender and say, hey, make me something frozen and red. And the bartenders got super into it, and they were really making us some fun creative stuff that was different colors. And so we got pictures of it last time, but not video. So we're going to video it this time and hopefully get some good stuff. I will say we are going to get like the regular glasses. We're not going to use our handy-dandy mugs. These are massive. One of these will last us like an entire afternoon. That's way too much, and I don't want to die today. So regular glasses it is. We'll probably ask for like half shots. Don't tell anyone. Just so we can try everything as it's meant to be.
Queen's Pearl for dinner tonight. Take a look at the menu. I know I'm gonna do the fish and chips. Pretty sure Hannah's doing the butter chicken. And you know I'm doing that rich chocolate brownie for dessert.
I'm definitely getting butter chicken. It's not like maybe getting butter, it's definitely butter chicken.
To be fair, she's been talking about the butter chicken basically since we got here. Our entrees are here. Hannah has butter chicken. She was very excited for this. This is the only thing on the menu she even looked at. Yeah. And now you can see why.
The chicken tastes like a little overdone, like it's a little bit too overcooked, like dry.
Yeah.
I feel like it's white meat or something. Excuse me. But it's really good. It has a good spice to it, it has a good kick to it. Which again, I don't expect these resorts. They're very like American.
One size fits all cooking.
Yes, to be spicy. And so I get really excited when there is actually like a kick to something. And I won't call it like super duper spicy, but I can recognize when something actually has like an attempt at spice. And
which means it's going to be quite spicy to me because my mouth isn't dead like yours.
I don't think you'd find this spicy, Joe. If you have like any amount of like spice tolerance, you'll probably find this good. You have no amount of spice tolerance, it'll be like, oh my god, you take like one bite and you'll die. I have a stupidly high spice tolerance because I'm from Louisiana and that's what we do. We grew up eating cayenne like you might salt, amongst other spicy foods. Also, I just like spicy foods. But yeah, highly recommend. Very good.
I got the fish and chips because I'm a basic white bitch. And I'm very excited. This is a pretty hearty piece of fish. Looks very fried. Oh my.
Bit of a crunch.
Gonna be some crunch.
I'm not gonna put anything on it for the first bite. I just wanna sample it as is. Lesson learned, I'm gonna blow on it first. Okay. So first impression, it's very crunchy, it's very breaded, it's very good, but it's very bready. I like it though. It's a pretty hearty piece of fish. And I'm mad at that. The other half, chips. That's just your basic, it's your basic steak fry. It's pretty good. Maybe a little more salt. Need to catch up. That's not bad. That's pretty good.
So for dessert, we both got the chocolate brownie. And I love chocolate, so this is something I'm very excited about. In fact, we're going to take the non-chocolate thing off of this and try it right away.
This thing looks chocolatey as hell.
Oh, that thing. It cuts so beautifully. It's dense, but not too dense. It's not like a dying star.
Almost like a cake?
No, it's not cake either. It's definitely a brownie, not a cake. But it's not like super ultra dense. So I think I'm going to like that because this is kind of a big piece. It came out, I'm like, ooh, that's a lot. We should just split one. But because it's a little bit lighter, but still has that very good chocolate flavor to it, it actually works quite well. In fact, like I said, normally I do love a nice, dense, gooey, warm chocolate. This is warm. Maybe not quite as dense, but something you're still going to enjoy and still have to eat an entire one and be like, that was good. Or split one. Nah, you don't want to split one.
So we just came out of the pub. Weird note about the resort. Look at that. Piano. Yeah, piano.
This could be fun.
Oh, piano. What if you sat down and played the piano?
What if I just, like, press a few keys because I'm chaotic like that?
Oh, wait. You can't. It's literally just a decorative piano. Ritual. Every time we come, we take it over to the sushi place, make a burrito out of it. Yeah.
Na 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 na. Hey hey hey. Saki bomb.
You'll forgive me if I don't narrate this part much. It's so good. Everyone thinks it's gonna be so gross, but it just never is. It's so, so good. It's wonderful. It's so good. I'm so sad, so happy. Sandals, seriously, get at me. Let's talk, Sandals, you and me. Let's just sit down and talk it out, okay? You don't have to name it after me. Just a small plaque in all your sushi restaurants. That's all I want. We can talk about it, it's okay. Your people can call my people. It'll be okay. At the very least, tweet me back, cowards.
Breaking out.